2030. Basically by digital transformation, we mean it is incorporation of computer based technology. I call it ITification in an organization ecosystem, products, processes, and strategies to better engage and serve, which is called empower the workforce and customers so that they can achieve better productivity, ease of working, and quality of experience. And we will see how it is to be done by digitally empowering the people, which most of the speakers have mentioned, to bring stamp jump in flexibility, agility, efficiency, responsiveness, and productivity. And for that, what we need, and that will be the key as a technology, by providing reliable, secured, and high capacity connectivity to homes for work from home or work from anywhere. That is the theme of this. And by capability building, so we'll coming to that also, and various technologies which have been discussed and which are required for all these, to especially to achieve those UN Connect 2030 goal, which Saravanans have mentioned. You already know 5G, Wi-Fi 6, beyond, IoT is coming, Industry 4.0, that is AI, ML, IPv6, which I'll be touching upon as Dr. Subrat have also mentioned. And another one is called blockchain, that is also very, very important. DLT, distributed ledger technology, and social media. So these are the technologies. But if you go next, actually, Dr. Subrat, next. Next, please. Yeah. So I have coined the 3C of digital empowerment. For digital transformation, we need digital empowerment of our people, like our team member, workforce, and also our customer. Both have to be digitally empowered. And the work from home comes there. So these are the 3C, actually. They say it all. The first C, and that is the most important one, is the connectivity. Like Dr. Subrat was mentioning about the work from home, lot of liberalization happened, actually, what our senior DDG was also mentioning for OSPs, work from home, bank guarantees removed, permission removed, registration removed, and you can use a normal connection. Earlier, for work from home, you needed a lease line or a VPN, and VPN also service provider provision VPN. But now you can do your own VPN, actually, and that is the key where IPv6 will be used. So in the connectivity, what you need is high speed, secured, robust, always available, end-to-end connectivity to all from anywhere to anywhere. That only can enable work from anywhere. And for that, we have this Digital India BharatNet, PM Vani, which Dr. Subrat was mentioning. No time is there to explain that further. We will have to have a separate seminar on PM Vani again. CS 2.0, MHSP, IPv6. All these things put together are bringing the connectivity to the home. And once that connectivity comes to the home, that is the backbone. And this connectivity now, it may be a normal broadband connection from a service provider or ISP. It may be coming through SIM card or through fiber or through copper. And on that, and that is what the biggest liberalization in OSP happened by government. On that, you can create your own VPN. Because in any official thing, work from home, if you are doing Facebook or you're gossiping or chatting, that you don't need a secured connection. But if you are working official work from home, then you need a secured connection, that is also called VPN, virtual private network. Virtual private network, earlier it was provided only by a service provider. But now with this liberalization, you can have a customer provisioned VPN. Customer provisioned VPN means you just take a normal broadband connection and then create your own VPN. For that, only thing is you need a separate IP address. Because when you take a normal broadband connection, you don't get a dedicated IP address, because IP addresses are not there with the service provider, especially V4. So they use one address and give to thousands of them through netting. That is called network address translation. But with the V6, you can give a IP address to every customer, because other, and free of cost. This IP address in V6 is available free of cost. So once you have got an IP address for each of your connection or each of your device, then you can create your own VPN that is called Customer Provisioned Virtual Private Network. And with that, you can have a secured channel, secured connectivity, which was very expensive earlier. And that is the main requirement. That is the backbone of digital empowerment and digital transformation. But that is the one thing that is not enough. What you need now is the content. The content also have to be digitalized. The content, the digital platform, then you are seeing it every day. Apps, India Stack is there, NPCI, Arogya Setu, Cowin, MyGov. So much content have been generated by the government as well as by the industry. This self-learning and learning from everywhere, what Professor was also mentioning, MOOCs are there, massive online courses, where you can do like Coursera is there, Khan Academy is there, our own IITs are there, NPTEL. So there what happens is these are the content, these are the platforms where content is there and you can get the content yourself. So as when Professor Shastri was talking about the teaching, so now you don't have to have teaching. You don't have to have teachers actually. What you have to have is MOOC, a platform where content is there, interactive content. And the teaching has to be converted to what I call learning, self-learning. You have to learn yourself. And that is what we have done during COVID. We have achieved so many certifications through MOOC, learning ourselves. No teacher was there. There was a platform, this Coursera. You just register any course you select, any university you select, and you learn, you download, you answer the question, quiz, you submit your what is called assignments. And then finally, you get a certificate also. For that, of course, you have to pay. Everything else is free. But if you want to get certificate, so it is self-learning. So no teaching, just learning. That is what has happened. That is a type of digital transformation on the education side. And then so many other websites are there in India, and that is the content for digital empowerment. So connectivity given, content. But third thing that is most important, what I want to bring, and that is the capability. You may have the connectivity, you may have the content, but you may not be knowing how to do it. When you are in office, you have an IT guy. If your phone is not working, your internet is not working, you go to that IT guy and he sets it right. But now work from home, who is your IT guy? Especially if you are aged like me, your sons and daughter, those kids, they help you. But suppose you are young yourself, then who will help you? You have to learn it yourself. Skilling for do it yourself. So you have to condition yourself, adaptation for using the technology, reskilling, upskilling, multi-skilling. There are a lot of government program, MSD there, NSDC there, IP Guru of NICSI have come. Skill universities are there, NEGD, NIE are there, so many. And recently, that is just last month, development where the government have created what is called a CBC. We used to have CVC, CIC, CBI. We were all afraid of those three C's. But now they brought another CBC, and that is Capacity Building Commission. The Capacity Building Commission actually creates the capability between you by skilling so that you can do it yourself. Because otherwise you cannot work from home unless you can manage everything yourself. If you cannot manage the technology yourself, you cannot work from home. That is what most of us are trained in office. We have an IT guy, we have a PA who will help us and all that. But now, so I always call practice digital skills or perish. You yourself have to learn, yourself have to do, otherwise you will become obsolete. So these are the three C's of digital empowerment, which are very, very important, especially if you want to work from anywhere. So next, Dr. Subrat, next slide. And this is some, of course, I'm not going this because this will waste a lot of time. These are what the emerging trends are happening. So what, because of saving the time, immediately, Dr. Subrat, if you can take me to my last slide, last but one. Oh, okay. This, let me just say this, because you wanted, go back, Dr. Subrat. This I wanted to show. Yes, this I am using in villages to give Wi-Fi. I've used Archimedes principle, where he told look around the world and the slightest push, you can just tip. Like Archimedes mentioned, give me a road long enough, strong enough, and I can move the earth. So what I did is I told, give me a mast long enough, strong enough, and I can change the lifestyle of the rural folks. What you do is in village, if you have a mast, if you have a mast or a pole kind of thing, you have a MARR, you, some of you know MARR, multi-access radio relay. Each village had a mast of about 15 meters. If that is there, nothing else is required. You can convert the full village into the hotspot. And that is where PM Mani will also be helping. And then everyone will have a Wi-Fi connection. So that I have actually used it, but there is not much time to explain further. So you go next, Dr. Subrat, and go back to the last slide. Because of the time, actually, last slide. These we cannot discuss at this stage. Last slide, please. Go further. Go further. Go further. One more. One more. One more. This blockchain is otherwise very important, but we cannot. And these technologies we have already talked. Last one. Next one. And this is very, very important. Actually, for the work from anywhere, learning from anywhere, what Professor Subrat. So I've coined a term, work-life blend. Earlier, it used to be work-life balance. We were taught work-life balance, okay? If you are in office, just concentrate in office work. Don't do private work. And when you are in home, don't do office work. But it never works, actually. It never works. In government, especially, we are 24-hour servant. So we have to keep doing, anytime a SMS or a WhatsApp or message will come from the boss and we will have to do. So it does not work. But now the technology have permitted us to work from home as well as homing from work. That means whether it is Saturday, Sunday, whether it is a holiday, that day you have holiday also, you have celebration also, but still you can do office work also. And that is the real digital transformation of work-life balance, what I call now work-life blend. It is reverse of work-life balance. So you use the technology to have best of both the world, actually making the work as pleasant as life, as play. So work-life play. Everything can be put together. And that is what COVID era have taught us, actually. During COVID era, we do everything at the same time or at the same place. We play also maybe on our rooftop or in our basement, and we do office work also, we do homework also. So that is called optimized work-life play. And that is what is the real digital transformation of how we work or how we live. So we have to be internet style, actually. Efficient, flexible, innovative, open crowdsource. We not only use internet as the connectivity, we also have to use the style of internet in the way we work and live, and communicate less, communicate more, commit less. That all of us know, trade-off between this, because everything you are. And there are these remote access, VPN, what I mentioned. A new thing is coming called SD-WAN, software-defined WAN. Both these things, and WhatsApp, may you have a WhatsApp business also, like you have Teams, Zoom. So WhatsApp also you can do business. It is not only for fun or forwarding those jokes and other things like Facebook. You can use web 2.0, telepresence, web conferencing. All these technologies are there. And then there are some technologies where you can work as a manager also. That is called Tattleware, actually. Sneak. Tattleware is where you as a manager sitting in your home, you can see how your employees are working, even if they are also in their home. So it is not only working at home, you can also manage from home. And for that, the Tattleware is there. And that, then there are so many other things. Digital is there. Human technology interface, smart contract, NFT. I cannot go in detail, but a lot of new technologies are there. But more than anything else, what COVID have taught us and these technologies which have become available, that we should not only make use of WhatsApp or Facebook. We should also make use of the LinkedIn, because your official work cannot be done on WhatsApp or Facebook. It can be done on the LinkedIn. That is the professional networking site. E-learning, I already mentioned, MOOC. You can learn yourself. Whatever, you can achieve an MBA degree, M.Tech degree, sitting at home. A lot of people have done during 1.5 years, actually. Skill, certification, qualification, enhancement. And you have increased your network, your profile, social intranet, what they call social capital. Network is your net worth. Means nowadays, it is not your bank balance which is your net worth. It is not the assets you have. It is network is your net worth. That means how many people are connected to you, how many followers you have which follow your blog. And that will decide, that is a Metcalfe's law, that value of a network is increasing square to the proportion to the square of the people connected to you. So if more people are connected to you, your value, your net worth is much more. Like Modi ji, our PM, like Amitabh Bachchan, means you see how many people are following them, and that is their net worth, not the money they have in the bank. That is a peanut against this network. And we have to exploit the capability of these tablets, home gateway, laptop, whatever, all these things. And it is not for yourself. You also have to digitally empower your workforce. That is very, very important. Whatever you are doing for yourself, same thing you have to do for your workforce also. So you'll become very, very efficient. And then, of course, mBanking, take your office wherever. If you want to work from anywhere, you have to take your office on the move wherever you. For that, iCloud is there, Office 365 is there, MiFi is there. So these are some of the things I wanted to mention. Unfortunately, time was not there. I could not go in the details, but this is the summary sheet. And next, Dr. Subrat. Next slide, please, Dr. Subrat. So this was mainly for me, and thank you very much. I'm really sorry to rush, but this is the summary. This is the main thing, because